As a facilitator, understanding how team members can reach a consensus is important for successful meetings. Also, it can help with coming up with quality decisions that the entire team can support. So, what actually is consensus? Consensus is discovering an acceptable proposal that all can support. So I bolded all in support because those are the two key words that you need to remember, that everyone on the team has to come to an agreement. Now that agreement doesn't have to be to like the decision, it just has to be an agreement to support the decision. What is consensus not? It is not a unanimous decision. So like I said before, not everyone has to reach an absolute agreement on the decision. They just have to be able to support it. It's also not majority rules. So if 70% of the team agrees to support it, but 30% don't, that's going to make it very difficult to have follow through or action items on that decision, because the 30% that don't support it won't cooperate as well as the 70% that do. And it's also important to understand that it's not 100% satisfaction of the team. Not everyone is going to love the decisions being made, but like I said before, they just have to be able to support it. So consensus requires a couple of key elements. One of them is time. In order to come up with those quality decisions, you have to discuss, be able to talk about opinions, concerns, and all of that can take time. It also requires active participation. You need people talking, discussing, being a part of the conversation. And not only do people need to be talking, but they need to be listening. And not only do they need to be listening, but they actually have to be open to what they're hearing and what other people are saying. Minds are like parachutes. They function better when they're open. So a couple of quick consensus checks that you can do with your team members is the Roman vote, made popular by Gladiator. It's really simple. It's thumbs up, which means I love the decision, I support it, to the side, which means that it's an okay decision, I might have a couple minor concerns, but I can still support it. Now, thumbs down is whenever you have major concerns and you cannot support the decision. If just one person has a thumbs down, they'll need to stop and discuss what those concerns are, why they have a thumbs down, why they can't support it, because they might have a valid reason that no one else in the room has thought about. If you have maybe just one or two with a thumb off to the side, you can probably move forward. If you have more than just a handful of people that have a thumb to the sides, you probably want to talk about some of those minor concerns that they have. And then the second one is the fist to five. It's very similar to Roman vote, just includes more fingers. So five is I love it, I support it. Four is I like it, I can support it. Three is it's all right, I can support it. Two, though, is when they start having some minor concerns, but they can still support it. One is I have major concerns, and we need to talk about it before moving on. And having zero fingers, just a fist, is I have huge concerns and I cannot support the decision. If you see anyone in the room that has a fist or a one, stop and talk about what those concerns are and have that discussion. If you have more than just a handful of people that have two, then let's talk about some of their minor concerns and then we take the vote. So those are just two of the consensus checks that you can do with your teams to have an effective meeting.